Today in Delicious Drinks, have you ever wanted to make top quality cocktails at home? Today's Providence Journal spotlights one mixologist who is the master in the art of drink making, and the cocktail guru himself, Jonathan Pogash, joins us this morning with his essentials for building a home bar. Good morning.
Good morning, Michaela.
All right, so first of all, we want to thank Cardi's for this fabulous bar that they brought in for us. And when you're making a home bar, you gotta need liquor, right?
You definitely need liquor, and one from each category. At least one bottle from each category. And when I say category, I mean vodka, gin, rum. So I have a vodka down here.
This is handy.
Yes, this is nice, isn't it? There's a little bottle opener here, too,
even
for
better.
Your beer. Van Gogh Blue Vodka. Mm-hmm. I have some rum. This is rum Clément. I have some cognac. This is Pierre Ferrand Cognac.
Up here,
I have gin, one of my favorite spirit categories from Givine. A couple flavored vodkas also, if you want to get a little nutty. I have a whiskey. You should have a couple different types of whiskey. This one is a rye whiskey, which is one of my favorite Rittenhouse.
Okay.
Mezcal and tequila. Now, tequila, this is from Partida. Mm-hmm. Today's National Margarita Day.
It is.
Yes.
I actually knew that.
So why not make yourselves a margarita at
home?
Why not? Mezcal is sort of the cousin to tequila, also made in Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have some liqueurs. Let me just come around here.
Sweeten it up a little bit. I like liqueurs.
Just to kind of vary things up a little bit, this is an orange liqueur, vermouth for your Manhattans and your martinis.
Yep.
Elderflower liqueur, this is Saint Germain. This is Marie Brizard, a couple flavored liqueurs, raspberry and triple sec for your cosmopolitans or your margaritas.
Yum.
Wine, of course. Let me come out around here. You have a Prosecco, Mionetto Prosecco for your sparkling wine cocktails.
Okay.
You have a champagne for sipping, for enjoying with your friends.
Love that. Celebrate.
Yes.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
And this bar holds it all. I mean, that's a lot
it
of
does,
stuff. If you don't like one or the other, you know, you can, of course, mix and match whatever you prefer.
Absolutely.
Now, how about for the mixers? Because I know this is where a lot of people go wrong. They have a certain type of liquor, but they don't know what to mix with it.
Right. It's really simple. If you have a few essential ingredients, simple ingredients for your bar, fresh is better, definitely. So your juices, get your fresh lemon juice, your fresh lime juice. Juice these right before your event or right before you start your cocktail.
Okay.
Some high-quality sodas for mixing. This is Yacht Club soda. I've used them many times before. Ginger beer for your dark and stormies.
Great.
Some syrups. These are great quality syrups. You can also make your own simple syrup using just Domino superfine sugar with water, and that's what's going to sweeten your cocktail, as opposed to the pre-mixed margarita mixes or anything like
that. Yeah, sometimes those aren't as good. Now, when you serve the drinks, everyone sees a lot of different glasses. What glasses would you say are the basics that you should have at your home bar?
So basically, you should have a martini glass, which is right here.
You should
have your highball glass.
Okay.
Your rocks glass, a wine glass, which can also serve many purposes for different types of cocktails.
Yeah.
This, is, if you prefer plastic, these are.
I like these.
Plastic, yeah.
Just in case, you never know.
Just in case, you never know. That fell on the floor. And you're fine. Punch bowl, I think, is definitely great if you're having a large gathering.
Very versatile.
A pitcher as well, if you want to do a pitcher drink.
Love that. All right, now we have to mention this book that you have on the table, too.
Yes.
People who are trying their hand at becoming a bartender, you have a helpful book there.
Yes, this is the Mr. Boston 75th Anniversary Edition, and I edited this. 1,500 recipes.
1,500?
1,500.
Wow.
Some of them are my personal recipes, and some are from terrific bartenders from around the world.
Mm-hmm.
Great tips in here, how to make your own syrups. I forgot to mention that you should have some bitters at your bar as well.
I always need that.
So this is a great book available on my website, thecocktailguru.com.
Excellent.
As well as a full bar kit so that you're able to produce these drinks at your home.
What are you using?
So I'm using a Boston shaker. This is the mixing glass and the mixing tin. A couple different types of jiggers. This is for measuring out your ingredients.
Yeah.
And a couple types of strainers. This is called a Hawthorne strainer. That's a julep strainer.
Great. Well, we want to thank you so much for coming in.
My pleasure.
So many helpful items here. You can make up 1,500 drinks if you'd like, and you can learn more.
Yes.
You can learn more of Jonathan's tips and tricks, plus his recipe for the perfect Bloody Mary, by checking out the food section of today's Providence Journal.